You got too much chain. You got too much chain. Yeah, you gonna have to shorten that chain up.
So just like,
because you figure you got here or something like that.
Yeah, put the clevis through.
Yeah, and drop your clevis down quite a bit because you ain't gonna be able to get the knot right on down.
Okay.
Look, let the horse down. Seriously.
Seriously.
Seriously. Seriously. Seriously. We got to pull the clutch and everything off of it first. So you got to get the clutch, the flywheel, and this plate off in order to put it on the thing. To get all your tools and stuff off the car, guys, get that. Do not lay stuff on cow panels.
That's the
that chain laying up there, the plastic.
Come to play, and
I never been in an engine bay before.
Yeah.
See
this other hole right here?
Yeah.
Yep. Hole to hole. What you got?
This one over here.
Yeah. 24 inches of work. That's all I need to know right there.
24 inches. Hey, Luke.
Rotate.
So basically, if you look right here, that is a pretty good sized piece. If I could get my fat little fingers in there.
You'll notice this.
Yeah, I need a pair.
Stat.
Somebody hand me a pair of needle nose pliers. So.
Where's a good nurse when you need them?
Oh, you got a magnet. Want a magnet to pull that out?
No, it's aluminum.
All right, so does anybody see anything that don't look right yet? So here's what I want you to do. You need to look at each piston and each cylinder wall to the best that you can to figure out what's going on. All right. So first thing I notice is right over here. You see where the piston has been hitting the connect, the counterweight on the crankshaft? That's not good. That shouldn't happen. See right down in there?
So the timing was messed up.
No timing. That's not timing.
There's chunks of metal everywhere.
That's normal.
Yeah. They put extra in there.
It is for something that's had the cowboy dog shit run out of it. And there's a large piece of piston that's been displaced. At least I think it's piston.
That's what I thought.
Okay, good.
I thought it was.
There's a more bigger piece.
I can't get it out with this. But I want you to look at each piston and the cylinder wall as you roll the piston up and down. Okay? So where did the noise sound like it was at?
Where it's hidden.
No, no. I got a pick. I pulled it out already.
Oh, you got the pick?
Oh, he's reaching with his fingers.
I was looking for the pick.
So he's getting the pick back to the top.
That's not good.
Right, that's metal.
Oh, yeah.
See where it's hitting it?
Right there. It's cut a little groove on the side. Right there.
Hold on. We're going to need some more. Yeah. I'm walking all in your floor. So how could the piston possibly get to the crankshaft? It can't physically reach it.
Well, it came with too long a throat, came.
Well, on a cylinder and somebody cranked it, it could compress it. That's one way. The other way that could happen is if I had a bearing completely beat out to the point that the bearing was beat out moving up and down, right?
Yeah.
But obviously that's not supposed to be that way. So that's the first thing that I noticed that ain't right, whatever that is, okay? So now I want you to go through and look at each one, and then and I want you to shake the connecting rods, see if you got anything loose as you're turning it. Go through each piston and each cylinder and figure out what you see wrong. But obviously, there's some chunk somewhere that's missing. And for them to be in the oil pan, it's got to be. I told you how could the piston actually hit the crankshaft?
You said if the bearing was wore out, like.
Watch this connecting rod real close.
Oh, it's moving up and down.
Watch the connecting rod on the crankshaft.
Ah. It's moving up and down. Yeah. There we go.
There goes that play.
There's that play.
Yep.
That where did we say it was?
Passenger back.
Passenger side rear. How much? We just got through going over bearing clearances in the class. How much clearance should you have in the bearings on this thing?
Probably
1,000. Now, this one, honestly, on this engine, it's probably going to be more like a little over 1,000 to 1,500, but not 2. On that engine, it would be 1,500 to 2. This one's probably going to be like, and I'm guessing because I haven't looked it up yet, but I want to say on this engine, it's probably going to be from 7 10,000ths to maybe 1 13 or 14 10,000ths is what I'm thinking. So if you see it, that's my guess. Like I said, I haven't looked it up yet.
But that's why that piston has come down further.
Correct. What's happened is under compression, the piston is pushing down further than it's supposed to because the bearing's completely gone in the connector.
It spun
the bearing. So you can pretty much figure it's like the crankshaft out. So you probably could order a rotating assembly with crank rods and pistons and clean the block up and put it back in if it hadn't messed up a cylinder wall. Problem is, I don't see the rest of the piston yet. So if the piston came apart in the combustion chamber, where would it go? The piston would come out the exhaust, right, if it made it through the valves. For it to get in the oil pan, it had to come apart somewhere in the bottom half. So if we keep turning, we should be able to find where those parts came from. But you can see once you unload that one, you can see exactly that one. I mean,
that's quite a bit of movement.
Yeah. So what I want to do is let's look at the rest. We'll snatch the bearings out of it and see. But what I want to do is let's go to the rest of them and. So let's do these while we're up here. There's another one somewhere. So you should have side-to-side clearance. Yeah. Hey guys, y'all need to come over here for a minute. If you're at a point, you got it tight. So you notice how none of this is moving. Everything's tight when it's turning. Mm-hmm. Remember I told you I saw that where you can see the marks right there where the piston hit the crankshaft? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That is never supposed to happen. So let's check this one. So right now you're under compression, right? So let's back off of it just a hair. You see how everything turns with it and it's nice and tight? Now that don't mean we don't have another bearing almost shot, but when you get up here and you look at this one, watch that connecting rod. See the connecting rod move independently from the crankshaft? You should never have that. Remember I told you, you should have a thousandth clearance.
Right.
Not 30,000th clearance. So I would say, since we're here and we see a problem, let's go ahead and pop that connecting rod cap off. But before we do that, obviously that one's junk. Mm-hmm. You would never just put a bearing back in it and go run it. I'm not gonna say it's never been done, but you would not do that. I mean, if I was broke down in the desert and I wanted to go home, I would do a lot of things that I wouldn't normally do, but I would never, I mean, at this point, you have to find where all that aluminum came from. And at this point, you don't have an option. You tear it apart. There's been metal run through it. The oil pump's trashed because you're running metal slivers and stuff getting through the pickup. So you know some of that made it through the pump going into the filter.
Yeah.
If you cut the filter apart, you're probably going to find metal in the filter. So, I mean, at this point, especially something that you already know has had the immortal crap run out of it, and it's turned high RPM, it's a manual transmission. You know somebody's been missing gears and turning it 7,000. And I mean, just, it's a manual. You can't help, it's a manual Mustang with a V8. You can't help but turn it. I mean, somebody's turned it, the hell wouldn't have it, and then hell came back with it. And now it broke. I mean, when you see air conditioning eliminator stuff, all the AC took off, you know.
Let's run.
They put a puke tank on it. It may have a ring land broke in a piston. I mean, but it's a 4.6 Mustang. You can get all the parts as long as your wallet can handle it. In God we trust, all else pay cash. That's the way it works, man. Jackie, how many times have you heard it, man?
Monday.
Yeah, yesterday. Right? Give him a little sympathy there. Let him know what it's really going to cost to build a hot rod.
How long is your wallet?
If you turn around in that corner over there, you'll see what a real expensive hot rod costs. Mm-hmm. Then you'll go back and be glad you ain't spending that kind of money.
It's a Mustang. Parts are readily available.
Yeah, yeah. That's the cool thing about a Mustang, man. I mean, parts are cheap. I mean, relatively, parts are not that expensive.
Compared to other things.
Right. I mean, I'm a Chrysler nut, so when you start building Chrysler products.
Chrysler is the most expensive thing other than a Mercedes.
I was going to say, you about build a Mercedes when you're building Chrysler parts nowadays. Anyway, so let's snatch the connecting rod off. Let's see how bad the crank is. I still can't see the rest of the piston. I don't see. Let me see you. I still don't see the rest of the aluminum part.
Mm-hmm.
What's that, an 8? Eight or 10.
I'd sell it to him if he offered me much more than that.
Eight or 10.
Straight 50. 10. Look like I'm going to say 10. 10.
Rainbow.
See how big the chunks are in there? Mm-hmm. There's big pieces down in there. That's the reason I didn't want to turn the thing over when we were hunting for parts. Because if you lay all these parts up here, you can start to see. I mean, there's a radius curve. See that radius curve?
Mm-hmm.
That's like a ring land, the bottom of a ring land, a part of a piston, almost guaranteed. See the way, I mean, that's. And that's why it didn't come out on the magnet. But I am surprised when we fished around in there with the magnet the other day, we didn't get